Hi, in this video, we will know how to personalizing the grid. You can personalize grid formats and save the changes that you make to the order of grid columns, font styles, colors, data sequence, or any combination of these features. You can create and save multiple formats to show different views of the same grid, which enables you to work with specific data more easily. For example, you can change the column sequence, change the record sequence, change column text properties, change the display and order of the columns, change the column background colors, freeze and unfreeze columns. Note, if you do not see the personalize grid icon in the bar located at the top of the grid, you do not have permissions to personalize the grid. You may contact your system administrator to get the access. Let's go. Note that the system displays address book records in a grid format. You can create a new grid format by using the Personalize Grid button. Note that the name menu displays create as a default value. The display and order list shows the columns and the order in which they are currently displayed in the grid. The available columns list shows all the columns that can be included in your personalized grid format. Click the Remove All button. Note that the system no longer displays any items in the display and order column. You can now add items in this column from the available columns list. Click the address number list item. Click the Add button. The system displays the address number list item in the display and order column. The system automatically selects the next list item in the available columns column. Click the alpha name list item. Click the Add button. Add the list item SCH tip to the display and order column. Click the SCH tip list item. Click the Add button. You can use the change order up and down buttons to change the order of the selected list items in the display and order column. Click the column up button. Note that the system now has changed the order of the columns. To minimize the display and order menu, click the display and order menu. Next, we will see how to format columns. Click the column format menu. Click the select column drop down menu. Click the address number list item. Use the spectrum bars to determine the column color and text color of the selected column. Changing colors makes the column more noticeable on the grid. Click a color in the column color spectrum bar to choose a color for the background of the address number column. Click the column color. The system enters the hexadecimal number that represents the column color. Click in the text color field to select the desired color for the column text. System enters the hexadecimal number that represents the text color. Next, you can save the format and review the personalized changes in the grid. Click the Save button. Click in the Enter New Name field. Enter the desired information into the Enter New Name field. Enter Demo Grid. Click the OK button. Note the new grid format name in the name field. Click the Close Side Panel button. Note that the grid format drop-down menu displays the grid format that you recently created. Click the Find button. The system displays the following personalizations you made to the grid format, the three columns and the order that they appear as you selected in the display and order menu, the font and the column color changes to the column address number as you made in the column format menu. Next, we will see how to use the data sequencing menu. Click the Personalize Grid button. You can use the data sequencing feature to choose the column that determines the sequence of rows in the grid. Currently, the system uses address number to sequence the data in the grid. In this example, you will use the list item alpha name to sequence the data in the grid. Click the Remove All button. Click the alpha name list item. Click the Add button. Click the Save button. The system displays the columns based on the alpha name column in alphabetic order. Click the Personalize Grid button. Next, we will see how you can use Request to Publish, Reserve, and unreserve buttons in the grid format manager. Click the name menu. After you create a grid format, it appears under the personal heading of the name menu. This grid format is available only to you. Your administrator grants you permission to publish the grid formats. If you do not see the request to publish button in the grid format manager side panel, you do not have permissions to publish, share or reserve the saved grid formats. Click the request to publish button. Note that the Request to Publish button is now disabled. Click the Name menu. Note that the Demo Grid format is under pending approval. This indicates that you have requested your grid format to be shared with others. You can see your format under Shared only when your administrator approves it. Your administrator can either approve or reject your request to publish. You can modify grid formats that are at the pending approval status, click the reserve button, note that the reserve button is now disabled and the request to publish button is enabled, click the name menu, you can use the reserve button to make the grid formats available for you to modify, note that the demo grid format has moved under the personal heading again, this indicates that you can modify the grid format and request to publish again. Next, we will see how you can freeze and unfreeze columns. Navigate to the Sales Order Detail Program, P4210, from the Fast Path button. Use the Customer Service Inquiry form to freeze columns in the grid. Click the Find button, right-click the Sold to Sell, click the Freeze option. Note that the system now displays a blue-colored line to the right of the Sold to column. This indicates that the columns up to the Sold to field are frozen. Drag the scroll bar to the right to verify that the system has frozen columns up to Sold to. Press the left mouse button over the scroll bar and drag the mouse to the desired location. Note that when you drag the scroll bar, the system does not shift the Sold to column and the columns to its left. Release the mouse button, right-click the Sold to Sell, click the Unfreeze option. You can drag and move column headers to reorganize grid columns on the grid. Next, you will reposition the Sold to column to the right of the Sold to name column. Press the left mouse button and drag the mouse to the desired location. Notice that the system now displays the Sold to column to the right of the Sold to name column. You can choose to save or share this grid format. Click the Close button. You have successfully personalized grids in EnterpriseOne. If you like this video, please like it and subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.